In my experience, Chandigarh today is at the verge of seeing many interesting businesses. I've met a few very interesting ones over here, not only in the traditional manufacturing or the agrarian ecosystem, but also businesses that are looking to enable themselves with the help of technology. What difference do you see in the entrepreneurial ecosystem of Chandigarh as opposed to what it was 5 years ago, and how do you envision it 5 years from now?
Sure. So being closely associated with the startup ecosystem of Chandigarh and having seen the ecosystem build up from ground zero, from last 10 years I would say, things have changed a lot at the grassroots level. I'll explain how. So in a hindsight, when you take back the story to 5 years back, when it was really hard to find the worthy audience as well as speakers at events like these, to this point in time where you get to see new set of people coming to each event, you know, that you go to. So I would say, and I happily admit and comment on this thing, that I get to see at least 80% new audience at every event which is happening over here, which means that the people who are graduating from their learnings from an event and implementing that to build their businesses are encouraging others to come back to forums like these to learn and, you know, be associated with the ecosystem. So we see a lot of new startups building up from this region, which was really known for the IT outsourcing ecosystem. If you look at the scenario in Chandigarh, you see the economy is majorly driven by the services industry.
Correct.
And specifically going into where most of the startups used to be inclined,
right,
it used to be the IT services sector. By looking at several stories emerging from this region contributing to almost 4,500 crore rupees in the IT outsourcing from the region, the exports happening from the region. So the story was actually going unidirectional until all the startup wave started happening, and I'm really proud to be a part of this wave, individually as well as through the efforts of Chandigarh Angels Network that we've been building for last 3 years. We see a lot more innovation happening in diverse areas like manufacturing, food and beverages, consumer retail, lifestyle, and healthcare. I would say there are several startups innovating their way out in agriculture as well. In fact, recently one of these startups from Chandigarh got funded by a VC fund in tune of $4 to $5 million, and they are innovating the agriculture industry. So you know, this is the kind of change that we have seen in the ecosystem, where people are no longer holding themselves back from expressing themselves. They are regular to the events where investors are found, where fellow entrepreneurs are found. They are potentially looking out for their co-founders. They're open towards sharing their failures, I think, which matters a lot in any ecosystem. And they're learning from their past mistakes and, you know, somehow relating back to the people who are coming new to the ecosystem, teaching them as well. So there's a lot of give and take happening, which is maturing this ecosystem.
Sure, in your estimate, what kind of businesses are actually mushrooming in Chandigarh?
So as I told you, there are several sectors which are emerging at the moment, where majority of these startups are coming from.
Right.
And now, given the backbone of the ecosystem is IT services businesses, you know, which are are the large contributors to the overall pie of the ecosystem, there are a lot of technology startups coming out from the ecosystem. We hadn't seen the products being built for the global audience, the B2B software as a service products, you know, being built from this region, but now that is happening. So off lately I've been meeting several startups who are building solutions here in this city, but for the global markets. There have been founders from the city who have taken exits, and you know, a lot has not been said about them because somehow Chandigarh was a bit secluded earlier. But you know, with you guys now being into the city, I'm sure a lot is being said. Interestingly, a founder has sold his company to Flipkart 3 years ago, And there are several more stories coming out from the region. You see, you know, startups coming from lifestyle, e-commerce, then, you know, consumer retail, food and beverages for the love of food in the city. And a lot, you know, a lot of innovation happening in the healthcare, because, you know, the city is actually, you know, largely occupied by elderly. So the elderly care, the senior care, and the healthcare services on demand is something, you know, which is rising at the moment.
Fantastic.
So a lot is happening on that ground.